This is Goji Kaicho and Worldwide Goji Kai Podcast, and we're doing a in-between episode tonight of Hellgate 2038. This is a mod that came out a year or two ago, maybe a little longer than that. It's been around a little bit, and they fixed a lot of problems that they had with the original release multiplayer. They've streamlined it a lot. They've cleaned up the graphics. It looks a lot better and plays a lot better than that version, that the Korean version that was on Steam. So let's go ahead, let's get this multiplayer game started. So we're gonna go one and okay. And I mean, even this has changed. The loading screen has changed everything. So, okay, loading. All right, now we've got us a character here, level 2 marksman. Started out in Russell Square, just like in the, you know, the single player game. Basically, this plays like single player, only co-op. And you can join with other players, or you can run this single player. You only get so far on single player because just the difficulty level ramps up really fast, and the monsters are a lot harder to kill. So we're gonna go and we're gonna start with Asimov here. Asimov is a marksman. Yeah, the my favorite class to use. I like using the ranged weapons. So we're in Holborn Station, which basically, you know, you haven't missed really anything. So we gotta go talk to this guy. He's got a artifact to give us. Okay, so basically transmogrifying cube. So we're gonna take that, and that is gonna give us extra storage capacity. Then we gotta go talk to Murmur. He's going to tell us to go talk to people.
Sorry, did you want something?
Yeah. Okay, so we got to go and talk to this guy.
All right.
Okay. All right. Okay. Okay, gotta go to the access shafts and kill Zareth.
Never any trouble.
This is your standard thing where you gotta get the capacitors. Okay. And we're gonna get these missions just so we can load up on these missions.
Oh, good. Take care of yourself.
Okay. All right, so this guy, he's going to give us...
Make them bleed for what they've done.
He's going to give us this relic, which at level 50, that relic, that little item right there, that talisman, that you right-click on it, you have to have a level 50 character to enter the arena. So it's an arena, endgame arena. So we're going to put that there. Okay, that there, that there, that there. Okay, yeah, good. All right. Now we're going to go in here, and we're going to start blasting shit. The Holborn access shafts. Oh, hi. Yeah, zombies are always easy to kill. Already got 5 capacitors, what the fuck? Holy shit. Okay. Oh, another one of those things. All right, now we gotta kill this Zareth thing. Oh, what the fuck? Oh, there he is. Oh, fuck. Oh, I hit the wrong button. God damn it. Okay. You know, got a bunch of free shit. All right. Bunch of bat zombies. All right, here we go. Sorry about my voice cracking like this, guys. It's I had COVID last year, and I'm having to deal with the fact that I've got a problem with my throat now. It's done damage to me. It's just lasting damage from COVID is what this is. Go quiet. It's not that I'm, you know, that I am focusing on the game, but I'm also focusing on resting my voice. Oh, look, here's one of those. Okay, nothing moving. Oh, nothing in there. I feel so gypped. All right. Just basically gonna go through here and kill anything that moves. We'll probably have to go back through here again later. Whoa! It's just run and gun, shoot and loot, you know. This is just early game stuff, you know. I'm just hitting the early game loot. Nothing. Oh, wow. All right. Russian rat monkey thing. Oh. Oh, I see. Rat monkey claw relic. I don't like rocket launchers. As a rule of thumb. Okay. So I haven't really gotten anything like... Okay, to... Alright, here we go. Let's... Whoa, shit. Oh, motherfucker. Die! Alright, let's see. Recon. Demolitions. Let's go. Grenade. Because we're gonna need that. And one, two, three. 4, 5, okay, 19. All right, wait, where'd it go? Did it disappear? Nope, there it is, okay. Yeah, if you hear that chiming noise, I'm sorry about that. This Bandicam only lets me do screen recording for 10 minutes at a time. So that just means my time is up and I've got to kind of like stop right where I am and then not exit out of the game, but like, pardon me, but go and start the recording again, so it will pick up where the other segment left off. I'm getting better at it, but the timer is just I know it probably picks up on my headset mic that I'm using, but yeah. Okay, we're almost there. We're almost out of here. We can go and turn this mission into Tech Smith and... Okay. Go to the Tech Smith. See, look, there's somebody legabbling the crate crusher. And then there's Don Don.
Never any trouble.
Hey guys, I'm sorry. You're kind of semi-famous now. Sorry.
Death together, brother.
Yeah. Well, I'm not gonna do that just yet. Right now, I'm gonna go sell some shit, make some money. Cause that's what it's about in the early game. You gotta make that money. But first. I want to see something. Okay. So I can do this and then sell that. Sell that. Sell that. Sell that. Sell this. Sell this. Sell this. Sell these because I don't need power packs. This right here I can buy. And that does more damage, so I can get rid of that. And then let's see. This needs tech and ammo, so I can buy tech for it right now. Put the mod in, and away we go.
Farewell.
Now, let's go kill some zombies, guys. There's some zombies up here in Tottenham Court Road. Now, all of this is procedurally generated, which basically means it's different every time that you play. unidentified stuff. All right. Always, always shoot boxes when you see them. In this game, always shoot boxes. Yeah, there was a big thing to do today about Black Pants Legion. Their channel on YouTube got hacked by a bunch of crypto bros running a bot that was like, it changed the name, it changed the channel name to like Tesla, like Tesla something, and started running that melon husk thing, you know, about lone skunk or whatever. Two zombies dead. All right, caterpillars from hell. All right, but yeah, they we all got together on Twitter and basically told YouTube, you know, in no uncertain terms, hey, you know, we're not going to let this stand. I mean, Tex has worked so hard on putting that channel together and being the voice of, however reluctantly sometimes it seems, that, you know, he's kind of like the voice of the BattleTech community. And we, you know, just to show our appreciation for him, the BattleTech community just came out for it, and we basically showing our support for the guy and helping him get his channel back, because damn, nobody should have their channel hijacked by a bunch of crypto bro nonsense, and shouldn't let these fuckers get away with it. You know, YouTube really needs to stop falling asleep at the switch with that. That is probably like the stupidest thing ever that I've ever seen. Is that they allow that shit to happen. Okay, yeah, that does not work the same as it did in the single player game. That definitely does not give you the same amount of loot. Okay. Well, where? Oh. Yeah, zombies, they're a source of money. All right. Oh. Death maggots. Death maggots come from the sky. If you know what song I was trying to sing there, then good for you. Death pod comes from the sky. Oh my god. Yeah, good old Gwar. They're a fine kaiju band. I mean, that's how I classify them, at least. They are a kaiju band. All right, let's see here. That, okay. Thermal bolter. I hate thermal bolters. Those are the worst weapons in this goddamn game. All right, let's see.
Oh, good. Take care of yourself, okay? Here it comes.
All right, what does he want? Oh, the blood zombies. We gotta go back and get this kid's leg stick. All right. Let's get up here. Nothing has respawned, which is good. So this will just be a straight out and back. All right. I mean, there's even smoke and weather effects in this game, which that's really cool. All right, so okay, we got his leg stick, his gimp stick. Ooh, napalm strike. I like that. We're gonna do that. What that does is it throws a beacon out, and that gives you, ooh, hey, 10 points to spread. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. All right, next we're gonna start spending on strength so we can actually up the weight of armor that we can use. So, we can eventually start wearing heavier armor. So let's get back down there and let's give the kid his gimp stick back. And then go and kill these blood zombies after selling some shit that we just looted. Let's speak with little Joey. All right,
You want to
speaking with little
ambitious?
Joey. All right, come here, give me the gimp stick, kid. I'm gonna sell it anyway. All right, so we gotta. Okay, that's on our mission after this one. So we're gonna go and sell
I
some
will
shit to
adequately
Orph.
equip you for your adventure.
Oh, the voice acting in this is just amazing. I mean, this is one of the earlier games that has voice acting that's worth a damn. I'm getting that because it ups critical damage, and I need that for my gun. I'm gonna let that sit there for a minute. Okay. We're not gonna do that just yet. Ooh, but a Zeus rifle. A Zeus rifle. Laser gun. Flamethrower rocket launcher. Thermite rifle. I'll think about it. I will think about it. Those are not weapons I'm really keen on. Look at that. With that, my gun does 50 damage
Okay,
now.
goodbye.
Oh, it's a special gun. All right, let's go kill some of these blood zombies. We got three of them to kill. It's not gonna be much, but we'll see what we can do. Yay, collateral damage. Destroy shit. All right, well, we know the gun works. Okay. There's one. Boom. Oh, I hear one. There's two. Where is he? Come on. Regular zombie over there. sometimes in between visits to a zone, shit will just respawn. No real reason that it does, it just does. There is no god mode for this game. There's absolutely no... Whoa, shit. Boom. There's no god mode for this game. It's just... that hardcore. There's no cheat mode. No cheat codes or anything for it. The game you get is the game you get. And... you know, you either get good or you die. It's just, it is a very unforgiving game. Okay. So we're gonna walk through here real quick. See, the better you get at it, the better you get at this, the more shit tries to kill you. So, one more job for this guy.
Here it comes.
Okay, so we gotta go kill Typhoid Mary. But first, before we do that...
I hope that one day this all pays off.
Now, remember what I said about shit wants to kill you and will try to find ways to kill you. This game gets creative. Very creative. You will find yourself dying really, really freaking fast if you don't know what you're doing. So, let's see. 50, the Volt Rifle. I don't need a Volt Rifle. Let's see, however, I could use that. 19 and 7, 16 and 24. Let's go 19 and 17. Let's go 10 and 8, Trooper Jump Boots. Let's go that helmet. All right, now. There we go. Okay, now we're ready. Now we are, wait, I think. No, we're not ready yet. Okay, what's this? 8, 7, 5, 9, okay. Now we're ready.
Okay, goodbye.
Now we're gonna go and loot and shoot. So we're going here to Covent Garden Approach. We've got to kill Typhoid Mary, and we've got to kill some fell boars before we can get to Covent Garden. Oh, great. This is what I don't like. This is an ambush waiting to happen. Exactly what I was afraid of. Freaking hate those things. Stalkers, man. Get out of here, stalker. Imp trooper, goddamn imp trooper. Die. Personal relocation device. Yeah, the assault rifle in this game is not a precision weapon. Whoa, shit. You just pump ammo into anything that moves, basically. An analyzer. Nice. Okay. Whoa, shit. Another 20mm rifle. Whoa, what the fuck? Yeah, see, they'll just appear out of nowhere at you and kill. Just bleh, die. Now. All this way and we still haven't even found Typhoid Mary yet. A lot of you are probably saying, well, that's just the most overpowered character imaginable. No, it's not. You would not believe just how weak marksmen are. You've got to know what you're doing to play marksman. Lead them back up. Keep them at a distance. And then lay into them. Making sure all the shit around is dead. Good and dead. She's on fire. Okay, she's dead. And yeah, I gotta take this hit. Ah, shit. Okay. Ah, okay. Open this up. Put all of this shit in here. Okay, so everything's cleared out here. So what we're gonna do, let's go get this coin. And I wanna show you this really cool trick. Once we can get to a good spot to do this. Fuck. Just when you thought it was over. Okay. It ain't. All right, let's get in here. Yeah, the trick only comes handy when you want to go sell some shit to get it out of your inventory that you're never gonna use. Stuff that's just not class appropriate for whatever class you play. Okay, so what we're gonna do, we're gonna get over here and we're going to find a safe spot, or as safe as we can. And then we're gonna activate a personal relocation device. It's gonna send us back to, oh fuck. Okay, right here. This is where we're gonna do this. We're gonna do one of these. And then we're gonna go sell some shit. Okay, make a little money, turn in some shit. Okay, here we go, guys. Holborn Station.
Yes, sir.
Something I can do for you.
Something I could do for you. Alright. What is this? 5 and 3 accuracy plus 4. No. I mean, I could use more accuracy, but. Ooh, 987 power points is 6. Okay. No, I don't want bolters. I can't use that. I can't use that. I don't have anything that uses fuel. Or power packs. You just do this and you can keep racking up money. Alright, so we're gonna use that and we're gonna find out what that is. I don't like Firefox. Grenade launchers, god damn it. Alright. So, we're just gonna go back, and we are gonna go and continue from where we left off here, back into the Covent Garden approach. Look here. Ta-da. Alright, let's go over here and see what's over here. Nothing in here. Okay. Good, nothing lying in wait. Although I wish I could find some good S-Racks. Those are fun. Especially if you get them good, you know. Whoa, good set of S-Racks and you modify the hell out of them. You modify the hell out of 2 S-Racks and you just dual wield the hell out of them. Now we are at Covent Garden Station. Okay.
Always happy to help. Goodbye,
yeah,
my friend.
We made it. Let's go speak to Brandon Lan here.
Arthritic man. Back to work. Think they beat us, the bastards. Courage under fire.
All right. Sell the shit.
Upgrades will cost you.
Great.
For instance,
do I have a belt?
Pricey and
I do have a belt. This is a better belt because it's got armor. This I can sell. This I can sell. Let's see if he's got any S-Racks. Why, yes. Yes, he does. No ammo. Okay. Yeah, so let's put this here, and this here, and now we hit F2. Boom! S-Racks.
All sales.
We are dual wielding now. Alright.
Boy, you best learn something.
For God's sakes, man, put some respectable slip down.
You ain't gonna take a file. Hardy,
a
wonderful.
Hi there.
Good day.
Okay, you take care
now. Upper Kingsway, yes. Lower Kingsway. Lower Kingsway.
Excuse me? Bye.
Covent Garden Train Depot. Bag of Bones. Covent Garden Train Depot. Let's go do the sewers first, guys. Okay. Upper Kingsway sewers. Hey, Don Don. You're kind of semi-famous now. Sorry. Okay, back at it. We're going to follow Don Don into the sewers. We're not, like, following her. Oh, wait. We got to... Oh, yeah, that's right. We do, don't we? Okay, we're going to up the... Whoa. We're going to up the deadliness of our grenade. We're going to up the deadliness of that. Okay, we can't do that anymore. So 9... 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. All right. Now. Do. Okay, now these you can go. 1, 2, both. Good thing is with this, you can't run out of ammo. Definitely a close range weapon. So let's switch back to our rifle. Zombies, man. They've got like extra padding. Oh, slee stack. Fuck. See, so like rooms like this, these are basically you go and you just raid. and you get whatever you find, all sorts of stuff in these boxes, money mostly. Yeah, mostly it's money. Other times it's useful shit. First time I ever heard a zombie cry out in pain. Oh, fat boy, we're gonna have some fun now. Woo! Alright. Here we go. So I'm filming this. I am recording this episode before the Star Trek episode. So if that one actually comes out, you know, so basically, you know, this has already been filmed. I don't do any of my stuff live. I don't have the technology at the moment to do anything live. I just film it and then I put it up on YouTube. Basically, I don't like doing stuff live because it's like, you know, Tex once said about that live chat just scrolling at 900 miles an hour and you've got all these people watching. Not that I've got a lot of people that would watch my live stuff, but I just couldn't focus on anything. You know, I'd be like focused on trying to talk to the chat and trying to play the game at the same time, and it just wouldn't work because, you know, I know you can set that to go real slow, but I mean, I'm like, why fuck with it, you know? Press F to doubt. Alright. Finding a lot of analyzers and PFDs. That's good, actually. Because analyzers, you need those, and it's better to find them. The same with PRDs, personal relocation devices. It's better to just find them pop up, you know, as they pop up on the ground, you know, than to buy them in a store. Now, I don't recommend playing this the way I'm playing it if you've never played Hellgate before. Hellgate is not just a game that you can pick up immediately and think, you know, are you gonna be as good as this? I'm not good at this at all. I just make it look like I know what I'm doing. And half the time I make a mistake and I'm like, I go back and I play it and I'm like, I play it the way that it's supposed to be played and I'm like, oh, well, that, okay, that's where I went wrong, you know. All right. So let's see here. Okay. Roar. Oh, a rare imp trooper. Yeah, see if I find ammo, I will definitely put that in that S-Rack. I think both my S-Racks are moddable, so let's go here and bait these zombies. Oh, he's fast. Okay. Yeah. Wow, that was cool. That was fast. All right. Let's go up here. Let's look at our inventory. Oh, all of this. Okay, let's see. Go to our transmog cube. We're gonna put shit in here. So we can sell it. Fuck. Okay. That I haven't figured out. Beast F. Okay. Five of these are required to enter the maw found in Wake Hollow off of Stonehenge. So, yeah. Alright, whatever. Two, three, and I got five of these. Alright, so that one. Okay. Let's do that. Alright. Anything else that I missed? Okay, nothing. Let's get up in here and kill some shit. Stuff that needs killing? Anything in here that needs killing? Hello? We're here to kill shit. Anything in here need killing? Oh, okay. Mm. Nothing in there. I hate that. You go through there, you know, all that trouble, and then, you know, you end up in this area and you're like, oh, fuck. Let's go down here to this dead end and finish killing all this crap. Yeah, sometimes headshots won't kill these zombies. I mean, you gotta really make sure they're dead. Yeah, one of the developers of this game was Bandai Namco. Look at all of this shit. Okay, in there. Health injectors. Those are always good to have, and it's better to find them and bank them than it is to buy them outright from a store. Boom. All right. So here we go. And we are done. Now we gotta go get to this area in here. Back up in here. Right here now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a PRD. It's a PRD situation, people. We're gonna go back to the station, sell a whole bunch of shit, and then come back and do it again. All right.
I bet your ultra high-tech gear just wears out all the time. Doesn't it?
Nah, not really. No. See, that's the problem. You cannot negotiate for how much this stuff sells for. That's what I don't like. Okay, that gives me 2 shields, though. I'll keep that. Okay, alright. No. Although it would be more fun to have that, I just think that's too big a risk. Alright, weapons. Hey, another perforating S-Rack, and there's an aligned S-Rack. That one's 7% increased range. That one is shield penetration, 4%. Ooh. Let me see, what does this one do? Shield overload, okay. Yeah, we can't even do that. Now, we do this. Alright. Alright, so now we gotta get 2 ammo? 1 ammo?
My pee. It goes in like a lavine. Honey, a wonderful good day to use.
You are an inspiration.
He was real drunk. Okay.
Right now. Yes, yes, goodbye.
Alright, so you can augment the weapons. So let's go up here and see how much it's going to cost. Okay, to add a common property is 400. So this increased it to 54 damage per shot. So you can get these things really freaking amped. I mean really freaking amped. So let's get moving up here. Let's go to the lower sewers where we've got to do some shit. We've got to kill this thing called Big Ben, and we've got to, let's see. Kill Big Ben and kill Thelbors. We're going to take 10 blind eyes from Thelbors, and then we got to kill Big Ben. Basically, let's just kill anything. Adrenaline pills. We're going to end up. We're going to end up killing things, anything that moves, basically. Why won't you die? You're a zombie. You're supposed to fall apart, you know? I mean, that one did. You can shoot some of these zombies and they'll just... You'll see the legs just walking. And it's weird because they can still damage you. Okay, so let's see. 4. Oh, whoa, snipers. Kill the snipers. Die, snipers, die. Oh, holy shit, look at my health. I gotta really do something about that. Okay, hand gloves. Oh, fucking imp snipers. God damn you. New S-Rack there. Now, if I find a blue S-Rack, I'm keeping that thing and getting rid of one of the green ones. Cause it goes by rarity. Sometimes you'll find some really rare weapons in here. Just shooting things like this and you'll come across these things and you're like, wow, holy fuck, you know. Damn it. Couldn't throw it far enough. case you're wondering how I ended up back in there, it was the recording had stopped and the timer went off, and I had to hit both of those while I was being chased down by a zombie. And so just going around here making sure all these zombies in the vicinity are dead. Then I'm going to... Yeah, you always want to make sure all your targets are dead. Yeah, I'm definitely... It's a learning process with the software. It's... Okay, so come down here and go into this procedurally generated... What the fuck? Okay, die. It's procedurally generated hallway with all the snipers and the zombies and the hey, hey, hey. All right, die, 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 die. And the Hawaiian. All right. This weapon is nothing yet. Fuck. Oh, holy shit, the something, something, something. I've got ammo now. Two ammos, actually. Perforating and... Perforating. Nice. Alright. Okay, so let's perforate some shit. Ooh, a rebounding pistol. Oh, I can't use it, damn it. Oh, that one. Oh, that one. Oh, that one. Ah, I'm gonna try to keep that. Oh, what do we got here? 71 direct damage. Holy fuck. Yeah. That's a Raptor, which is a rocket pistol, and I don't need rocket pistols. A sniper rifle. I don't like them. Excellent. A lot of people are going, why don't you like sniper rifles? Well, in this game, they are hideously underpowered. Believe it or not, they are. They are underpowered. So we gotta go and get more blind eyes. So that means we gotta kill more of these fellbores. to do that, we got to go down further this way. So let's get up here and kill some Thelbors with the Demon Be Good specials. Oh, man. Where? Oh, dead. Okay. Don't ever come up behind me like that again. Those are hideously inaccurate. Okay. That's four, so I got six more of those things to go. One piece of environmental that would not destroy. You got this zombie stuck in the pose. Okay. So let's do this then. Let's back out. We're going to go back to our rifle. Our good old rifle. Now there's the further into the game you get. Now I've been playing the single player. And it has a void, it's the thing called a void rifle. Okay, so let's go down here. Okay, we're gonna go to our inventory and we're gonna do this. We're gonna open it up, start putting shit in. Now, eventually, you're gonna get to where you just start disassembling this shit. Because, yeah, you're gonna get to a part where there's just so much stuff and you can't really conceivably use all of it. Okay, so let's see, go ahead and take the thermal bolter. Take that and go out here. So we're gonna go out here. I think my timer's getting ready to go off again. Hang on a minute, guys. Okay. All right. On the move again. Okay, let's see if we can get this thing to launch. There we go. Watch this. Napalm. Oh. That's not good. All right. See, what did I say? You know, they're walking around on the legs that are fucked up. All right. Of 10. Alright. We've almost got this, guys. Okay, there's money. Free shit. Alright. Alright, this right here, guys, is where you start disassembling shit. Usually I start with the common shit. Just disassemble the fuck out of it. Thermal bolter, do I want to disassemble? Yes. Since I will never use that, and I'm not going to use a common gun. This right here can go there. Okay. And we're just going to start going through here and finding shit to sell. Okay. Which I think we've already done. Go us. Alright, now we go back to this. We open up another portal. That way we don't gotta walk all the way back. Believe me, I've done the walking all the way back thing so many different times, it's not fun. Alright, 5 and 3, I'm not going to be able to use those. Hello. New mission, Concord Market, so that'll be on our next to-do. Alright. Level 7 achieved. Okay, so we're going to increase this. Let's see, accuracy, one, two, three, four, five. Okay, so we've just increased stamina. All right, now we go sell shit.
I bet your ultra high-tech gear just wears out all the time, doesn't it?
No, not really. Oh, that's a question mark, so... Got 1 minute. Da, 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 da. All right. Five. Sell tech component. Sell sword. Sell scrap. Sell that, since those aren't really worth anything. This I'm going to demodify. Sell SRAC, sell that, sell this, sell this, sell this, sell SRAC, sell this, sell that, sell relic. Alright. This right here needs ammo and a battery, so I'm going to go ahead and buy a battery. Ammo's already in that. That's the critical ammo. That's bracing ammo. I don't need that. Alright. Anything else? No. Okay. Let's go and do a thing. We want to demodify... Whoa. We want to demodify that. We want to take all the mods out. So the mod can go there. That mod can go there. This gun gets sold. this gun gets modded. So 80 damage it is. Super gun. Alright.
Fools in this day part with their lives sooner than their coin. Off you go then.
Alright, now we go to Covent Garden Train Depot and kill imp troopers and vagabonds. Oh, what's this?
Yes.
Say this once. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Okay. Covent Garden Market and kill Egref. Which Egref? Well, he's another one of those monsters that has the yellow name tag over it. So let's go through here and. Oh, a rare zombie. Nice. Fucking imp, die. The legs just kick. Have at you! What are you gonna do? Bleed on me? Yeah. Yeah, okay. Okay, guys. Let's see. Let's juice it up. It's two. Oh boy. Fucking imps. Wow. Whoa! Shit, there's bag of bones. We just killed Bag of Bones. Now, we just need to kill imp troopers. Four. Only four of 16. It's gonna take a while. Fucking imp snipers. What's in here? Okay. Five of 16. Okay. We are making steady progress through this, guys. I've got a lot of these imp snipers, and I hate them. I really hate them. In there. places where you get bum rushed by them. Whole room full of them. I guess that hallway had some in there too. What's around this corner, I wonder? I had to wonder, did. Oh, pardon me, God. I got a little bit of a cold, guys. I'm just a little bit of one. Okay. Here we go. There we go. Yeah, I like to make sure that I've killed everything in here. All right, now we go back. All right, now we go back. Whew, holy shit. See, this is a lot, this is a lot more difficult. Pardon me, a lot more difficult to do than single player mode.
Excuse me?
Single player mode is not for the faint of heart. Okay, so now we gotta go kill this thing called Thang Snort.
Yes.
In
yes,
the steam tunnels.
Wonderful. Have you any money?
Okay. Battery, disrupting battery, fiery ammo, well, nothing to write home about. Let's go ahead and get some of these, get it up to about 25. Okay, then what we want to do is this. Yeah, we want to do this. We want to get one of these.
Skates, for instance, are most pricey and
8 and 5, stamina 3. Okay, yeah, that might actually help. Get a little bit more armor. Let's do this. Physical direct. Oh, wow, nice, nice. Increased physical damage by 10%. Nice. All right, now we go and we fight this. We look for this Fang Snort and Lord Sailor Moon. Yeah, yeah, Lord Sailor Moon thing, guys. Yeah. Okay, guys, here we go. Into the steam tunnels. Aren't they all steam tunnels, though? I mean, Get out of here, stalker. Bloody Tempest. Alright. Interesting. Okay. Hell dog. It's a hell dog that can throw fireballs. There's Lordness of Sailor Moon. And Fang Snort, both at the same time. Oh, crap. Oh, my God. Here we go, guys. Here we go. This is just... See what I mean? This is... Oh, my God. I am not good at this. That, and they gang up on you. They will fucking gang up on you if they can. Which, that's not a good thing. Never is a good thing. You gotta try to find a way to separate the two. Okay. Or just do this. Shit. Oh, that was a wasted grenade. Am I stunning him with these? I think I am. Oh yeah, there we go. Oh my God. Motherfucker. What did I just kill? Oh my God. Okay. There we go. Keep him down. Keep him down. Keep him down. Oh, fuck. Keep him down. Oh, thank God. Oh, my God. Okay, I'm going back this way, and I'm going to go turn these in. Holy shit. Yeah, Lord Sailor Moon was a lot harder to kill than I remember. Alright.
Hello!
Hello.
Yes, always a hello!
Alright, what yes, you got here?
Always a pleasure.
Gotta explore the Upper Kingsway sewers again. Yes, and I got money. Let's see.
You like it? You bought it.
Mm-hmm.
Goodbye.
Yes, yes, goodbye. Okay, I cannot augment that one. Can I augment that and that? Just one. Okay. And then 85 damage. Okay, let's go back to map the Upper Kingsway sewers and then probably just walk down in there and say, oh, hey, look. We were here. Alright, now we go down in here and we're gonna just walk around for a little bit, kill things. Hurrah. Money. Nothing in those. See, that's the one thing is those don't respawn. Whoa. Monsters respawn though. So basically we're just here exploring the sewers and alright. Love that napalm strike. Going around. We've been up here. Whoa. That's new. Alright. Nice. Okay. Now see, I can still do this as a single player. I don't have like all the other players bothering me and stealing all my XP and shit like that. I know, you know, I mean, people that do that like to play multiplayer, I don't mind either way. I mean, I play MMOs, I just don't play as part of a guild or anything like that. Basically, it's just part of my autism. I am a very introverted autistic. Sure, I'll talk to people online, but not that often. Alright, fat boy. So the graphics in this mod, they look a lot cleaner, they look a lot better than the original and that you would get in just vanilla. And this is right now, what I'm running this on is DirectX 9. I'm running the DX9 version. You get to see a lot more details in, let's say, the brickwork, you know, and details close up on the monsters. See, like, I can't really get in there without dying. And I want to finish this mission. This basically just a recon, walking through, mapping the upper Kingsway sewers for that hello person, you know. So okay, yay, now I can go back. Okay, let's see, go back. Oh yeah, I forget, I'm not selling any of this. Oh, fuck. Oh,
there's the war. Well, but not too well, I should hope.
Okay. All right, now.
My profits are up.
Your profits are up. Okay, now we don't need to go there. We got to go Covent Garden Market now. Okay, investigate the anomaly. Oh boy, here we go. Okay, investigate anomaly. Whoa, shit, motherfucker. Fucking shriekers, man. We're not here to kill those just yet. Whoa. Not here to kill those. Two of eight. Okay. Oh, hey, look, there's one. Three of eight. Not thriving for long, are ya? Thrive this, motherfucker. Okay. Did I kill it? I think I did. Okay. Going around here and there was a rare beastie that went through here. Oh. These are like mutant hell dogs. Okay. Hmm. Where? I hear him. Oh. Okay, that thing's dead now. Good. Oh, there are still a few tiny glitches in the game. Nothing game breaking, you know, I mean. The rift. Whoa. Damn. Yeah, they blink through terrain. Okay. Oh, and had to restart the recording again. Hopefully, it hasn't been that bad. So what we're going to do, guys, is we're going to do this. We're going to go, and we're going to go back to the station, sell some of this shit, because there is a lot of stuff in that Hellgate, in that Hell Rift, that we could loot. So we're gonna sell some stuff. We're gonna get done with the. We're gonna get the.
Good men pay all full right. price, you know, and they tip.
Yeah, whatever, dude. I don't like Richardson. He's a bastard. His merchandise is probably like shit quality. Oh, well, looky here. No. Alright. What is this? Hallowed ammo and jilting battery.
A pleasure doing business with you.
Hello, hello!
Okay, you take care now.
Smith, okay. Smith is this way. And then we gotta go breach that Hell Rift.
Yes.
Alright. Poisonous battery and poisonous ammo. Alright, alright. Okay. So now we're at level 8. Well, wait, wrong button. There we go. Alright. Now we can get Escape. Rebounder rounds. Basically, it's modified ammo. It has a chance to ricochet off of enemies and walls. Can't get overshield yet. I have to have tactical stance, a rank of 3. I can't get heightened senses yet. Okay, recon. What's this? Beacon. Okay, no. Sniper. Well, range and accuracy increased by 60%. Demolitions. Let's go better on that. Okay, so alright. 226. Alright, now we're getting ready to go into the Hell Rift, people. This is where we are most likely to die 3 or 4 times in the process of... Whoa. Okay. Interesting. Okay, now here we go. Oh wow, so much junk. Look at that. Oh my god. Yeah. Wow, okay. Interesting. Sack of folks. Neat. Garden Station, here we come. Time to sell some shit. Yay. Alright. Early game. This is early. This is a classic early game of Hellgate. You are constantly doing this shit just to make money. I don't like poisonous shit. Poison weapons, man, that's eh. Sniper rifles. Oh. What? Yeah, I'll keep those. Two of those. What is that? Medium health injector? Nice. Basic health injector. I'll probably get mediums at the next place. At the next, over at the next station.
Doing business with you.
So let's go and talk to Lan. Okay, so we gotta talk. Okay, we talked to Lan. He's wanting us to go and do some shit, I guess. I don't know. Let's do this. Okay. So, take the items. We gotta go to the British Museum.
My pee.
Blimey. We've got to find Shriekers in Bloomsbury and kill and take 8 Hearts of Rage.
Excuse me?
And 9 killed in Bloomsbury. Okay. Anything else? Does anybody else need anything? Are you sure? Okay. The last time I'm gonna check now. Okay. Well, I'm gonna end this here for the night. And it's a really cool mod. It's really simple to install. You just install it to the root menu of wherever you have Hellgate installed at, and basically will, you know, it'll run from your desktop. You don't have to really do anything, you know, to do it. It does not interfere with you playing regular vanilla, so you can go into your single player folder and play regular vanilla if you want. And I'm going to put in the description down below where you can download this. So it's a really beautiful, this is probably the best mod that I've ever seen anybody do for Hellgate London. And really, there needs to be more people playing this. We need to really get on this and up the player count for this game. In Hellgate London, you could probably find it on Amazon for fairly cheap, or you can download it not from Steam or any of the other services, because this will not work with the Korean Hellgate that was on Steam. And well, the Hanbit Soft, it won't work with the Hanbit Soft version. You have to use the actual flagship games, Bandai Namco and Microsoft version that came out in 2007. So, thank you for watching. And hey, if you liked what you saw, and you want to see more of it, go ahead and click like and subscribe. Go ahead and leave a comment down below. And I apologize. My voice is not as good as it could have been. I'm basically talking a little bit lower. And it sounds scratchy, and that's because of the I've got damage in here in my vocal cords from where I had COVID last year. And it did a number. I've started seeing that it's getting worse. So, it might be that I have to take breaks a little bit longer in between videos, but I'm still trying to get these things done for you guys. Hey, you guys like these videos, that's great. I make them because I love playing them. I make them because you like to see them. And that's what we're all about here at Worldwide Goji Kai. We show you the things that you like, to see. And whether that be me playing a game poorly or halfway decently, hey, that's really cool. Sometimes I can even show you a trick or two. Sometimes even, I can show you maybe a game you've never seen before or haven't, seen that often, didn't even know that it was still around. A lot of people don't realize, hey, Star Trek Online is still around. And it's still got a huge player count. This game, London 2038, deserves a lot more credit for what they've been able to achieve with the base game itself and cleaning it up and getting all of this beautiful detail. I mean, you can see, like, right here, these little water spots in the concrete and things like that. You wouldn't see that. All that attention to detail, right? Like in the rust and everything like that, you would not have that in base vanilla. So, well, that's about all the time we've got for today. And this might come out before the Star Trek Online episode. I'm going to try to film that one tomorrow. If my voice is good, it's up to it. But I will talk at you guys later on. All right, bye.